Alright, welcome to episode 48 of my Age of Wonders 3 Draconian Necromancer series, where I give my 5 allied emperor level opponents a 40 turn head start. Had some good battles sniping off some people earlier on the turn, continuing turn 77. Picked up some good ghouls. Was thinking about attacking this stack. Very little, there's only 3 machines, so that's easy enough to take out. Depending on how it would go, I probably would not attack these two. I wonder how many could, if I attack this way, it would pull in, it would separate out this and pull in these, which would be a tough battle if I could get people down to here, which I don't think I can. Yeah. People can't really do that. Most are not getting beyond this point, so it's a matter of can I form? That's another thing. Is it just going to be? It'll be 3 hexes here because I'll have somebody attack from here, which I think is okay. You got 1-2 or who would be nice. 10% of his own units. So if I want to end in three spots, I'm not going to be able to do shenanigans with this stuff. So at most, I'd have to deal with 4 machines. 5. But I think here's the most likely. So, she attacked. So if I move up, because this this is still the optimal stack. So I can't at 7, I can't here, but I could move here, but it's not. I need to take the MVPs though. I could go here, but I'm only going to be able to pull in 3. I don't think I'll be able to pull in 2. Unless I do a surround. This is the most realistic. It'd have to be like here, but there's not many people. So it's like 4A. I'm not gonna be perfectionist with it. Banshees have just not been performing in the way they need to. Need the heal. That guy can go die if he's split off. That's something I didn't think about. This is 40%. I need to shift somebody up, probably. But these are all important. So what I'd rather have. Well, I think it's what are the 2 most important? Because they're moving slow. Oh, no, it doesn't, so it pulls in. So, everybody here. can move one more. So I don't need to be pulling in. These two, if I went like this. So I'd have to get all three and attack into three. I just don't know. There's just not enough 12 now. So I guess it'll just be these two. Just fine. Three machines. It's going to be slow versus fast. And the thing is, I might have to disband them because I've been wanting to attack my flank. Of course, hopefully everybody can move back, so it's, what, three power stacks? Because I can move over here. I don't have to worry about that later. Move them separate. He's disposable. Because what I'm going to try and be here, so everybody needs to have three to be able to move there. I just don't know. I think I need heal. So disposable or disposable. Maybe this kind of disposable. I mean, I'd rather have them raised. I think we'll just do that. Alright. So who has plenty of movement? 12 might be the most. Who am I trying to, whose levels am I trying to raise? Who can guard break? He can guard break. Goes a long way, doesn't it? 29%. I think I like that better. Beautiful, my goodness. Stunts make all the difference. 95% are odds I like. Just one more, huh? And then he's stunned, and he won't burn out. So it seems appropriate. So anyway, I mean, if you move, he'll probably just ramp. So I think everything can chill out. Enchantress at 8. There it is. I hope he kind of kills him. So yeah, I'm just gonna chill Zoras for a bit. Good, excellent. All right. Now, that's great. I'd love to heal him. Also love to heal myself. How much longer is he stunned for? Good. Alright. What else needs to happen? It is stunned, so seven. It's getting pretty close. It is stunned, huh? Six, four, seven. Super close. Just an attack. So, I could fight attack here. I pull in those machines, which might be a good idea to do. It just depends on how much movement I have. And if I'm here, I need to form a new circle here. I'm not sure about that, but I think it is probably worth it. Level up. Oh yeah, I've gotta do some math here. I don't know, my sorcerers. Inflict spirit breaking at level 10, which with the type of people I'm dealing with is not as great. Projectile reflection. That is interesting. It dissuades people from attacking. Immobilize. One. It's just so expensive. Floating is interesting for the reasons mentioned. So, because the other thing is, Chaos Rift is 50, and that would require two more levels of sorcery. I'm surprised I have this much. Level 3 costs 7, though. So I'd have to do 3 more levels. So level 9. So at level 11, I could pick up Sorcery 3. And then, let's see, I gotta do this math here. Grab the pencil. Level 11, I've got 10 points. 7 would go to Sorcery 3. Level 10. Level 11, I have 10 points. Level 11, I have another 5 points. Level 12, then level 13 is Chaos Rift. So in theory, So level 11, I would have 10 points to spend. I'd need 7 of those. And so I would have 7 to invest how I wanted at level 12. But I could get Thunderstorm if I save 3 of those. I could get, if I save all that, level 14. Thunderstorm. So, and that would leave me with 2. I could invest in something else, otherwise I can get all that stuff perfectly. And 2 is not a lot, so it would be passing on Spirit Breaking. fire protection. It's pretty damn important. But when I'm in his army, it doesn't matter as much. There's just not a lot of twos. Dispel magic, break control. Ranged strength. Ranged strength is interesting. So would I rather have break control because of the arcane binding stuff? I'm probably just going to sit on the points. But for now, I'm floating at 4 points. It's so close. But I would rather not float and be able to do the plan. So I'm just going to invest in this. This would be 7 points. Okay. What else is happening here? So we do want to take this battle. Do you want to take it? Man, it would be so great to break them here. Especially with that guy down, if only I could find where the capital was. These guys are back here still. Now, he can't cast spells at a distance. I can actually do this now. And I definitely am. So we're gonna do this right here. Because his Bormak is in the void. Should not be able to reach me here. You can't get both of me. Forgot about that. Good job, team. What the hell am I doing? Get back on there. We'll go there. In fortress range. I can go far. All right, we do want to do this. I just have to think about where my true spaces will be. Is it going to be here? Because there's... Who cannot get here? So what, these three? Probably. So who do I want to include? I want to exclude him, so I don't want them in either of these spaces. So if I go here, I save them. I'm still doing the same strat. Are we thinking about moving her here? Yeah, I think I do want to get her into the battle. She does well against machines. It's pretty good. She's still there, so that's pretty good. And I could go here. Here. Well, I mean, if you can go there. She definitely needs to be up. Can all of these people go here? Now? Before we play the guys camp. To be able to go back. That's the thing. Do I have anybody with enough juice? Could be 3-3. Four, two, three. Can't summon anybody. Seven and then back, I guess. So they just need to be able to move once more. So maybe these three spots so they can move elsewhere. No, they might do that. So they can't move once more, so we don't want them to. They could. This guy is fresh. No, I can't do this because I could attack my flank. Can I just... I would rather get rid of these guys. Yeah, stuff to worry about later. So it's at 2 full stacks. These 3 can go back, and at least 3 can move back here. 3. They're not, neither of them are getting in the mix here. So this is my force, which against that level of machines is fine. So, I think we are ready unless I want to move up with him. Maybe I'll do. 1, 2, 3. So at least 3 need to be ready to back out. They won't be doing anything unless I move him up here. Because I really would like the heal. So who can be spared? I need the stuns. Probably gonna want him. So would I rather move him back and have this heal and greater reanimate, or would I rather have the damage? I hate doing this, but I think I would rather have the flexibility. Now, can at least 3 guys move back? Yeah, they can. Though the flame dude is interesting, though they tend to be slow. Yeah. Now, he can move forward and back. So that's what we're going to do. Man. And do I want to free up some mana? Who's got something that I'm gonna want to cast? Because they've got guys that I would like to ghoul. Although I don't know if I want to, because I don't want to be pulled in for a battle that I'm not prepared to fight. So I actually won't be ghouling any of them. So does anybody have so there's like the magic fist there. Force field. I don't think I need. I don't think I need to cast anything. So it's fine. We can roll with this. Please do run ahead. Make my life easier. Similar battle to last time, so we want to split them off. Probably with him. I don't have any banshees. That's fine. So we'll be to him. 15, 24, yeah. I'm just gonna. Alright. So much for knowing my ranges. So I have a chance to stun, it's probably worth it. Pretty good. Then lighted, especially. Ten, huh? What's your fire, like, fire protection for them? I don't want him to be engaged. One, two, and so these are the most dangerous. One, two, three, four. So I can get the time back if I can. So we might want to broadside. Forty-9%. This is the more dangerous. Damn. I can face this one. Maybe. That's good. Can't do it. This guy is who we need to worry about. So somebody does need to stand here if I move. And it could be him. All he's gonna do is blow around. But I would like to kill it. Would I rather kill it or stop the blow around? I don't think I need to worry tremendously either way. So I'm raising somebody from the dead. Two times three is six. Zero. Yeah. That's interesting. What would this 40%, 40%? Maybe I want to try this. Oh my god. Wonderful. What does dazed mean? Moving guard. Interesting. Alright, so she'll be back. Who are we giving experience? He's a long way off. Keep giving it to level 9. 509. 523. So I can't do that. But I'd rather get them up. So these guys need to get up on this. We can do this just as well. We can do this just as well as well. Percent, 56%. Depends on who I need to be worried about. I'm going to stunt. I don't remember anything stunt. Stunt for ones. Webbed. Webbed, okay. If they're stunned, we don't have to worry about them. No. Totally even. Miss seeing that, so we'll hear. We'll hear here. Where are good? Six. Dazed, so have to find my whatever it was. Where did it go? Did I eat him? Well, I must have eaten my horse. Must have eaten my knight. That was silly. Yeah, that was silly on my part. What rank was he? I don't remember. Level 9. So is she in the same position? So she has 40. We both have 40. She has 40 at level 9. He has 40. They're both at level 9. Okay. Right. 6 points. He has 6 points, huh? So one more unit of sorcery puts him at 50. Right. So they're my optimal 3 stacks. These guys I'm thinking about disbanding. But I think they might not be smart enough to attack this that way. And only pull on him, plus between these guys. Is this a static shield guy? No, it's not. Okay. Still, I think they would have a decent shot. now I have to mess up the battle over here. So we will do that. But, oh, we're already at an hour in. So I think I'll leave the episode here. So this has been episode 48, I think. See you in episode 49.